Good morning everyone, welcome to Ojaswat IAS Academy. So we are trying to cover current affairs in the form of MCQs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss MCQs of 22nd April, but before that you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. Also do take a pause when you see questions on the screen, answer it first and then see the explanation part. You can also join us on the Telegram channel where we can provide you PPTs daily. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So let's begin our today's MCQ. Question number 1 is with reference to World Health Organization Fund. Statement first, the member states have mandatory obligation to pay a certain amount to WHO. Second, US contribution comprised of the maximum share among all the countries. So if we see statement first in terms of contribution, it is incorrect. Second is correct, so option will be B, that is second only. So World Health Organization is a specialized agency of United Nations which is responsible for international public health and it was formed in 1948 and it is funded by country, philanthropic organization and other UN organizations. Also, countries decide how much they will pay and may choose not to contribute. And currently, US contributes largest share, which is almost 15% of the WHO's total funding and 31% of the member state donation, whereas India's contribution is 1% of member state donation. And the context is that the USA has decided to cut off US contribution to WHO, accusing WHO for failing to curb the early spread of the coronavirus and for being China-centric. This topic we have discussed on Sunday series recently. So if you haven't seen it, you can watch it on our playlist. One more thing is that we have already discussed regarding WHO's funding, where there are 4 types of contributions. One of those contributions were assessed contributions, which were must for the member state if they want to member of the WHO. And that was done on the basis of country's population and wealth. So if you are seriously following this series and you are learning this fact, you must be knowing what are the 4 contributions. One I have said, it is assessed contribution. Rest 3, if you remember correctly, write down in the comment section. In this way, you can recall the past information. Now, let's move on to the next question. Now, question number 2 is with reference to currency depreciation. First, currency depreciation decreases a country's export activity as its products and services become costlier to buy. Second, RBI intervenes to support the falling rupee directly in the currency market by buying dollars. So, here, both again statements are incorrect, so option will be D. So currency depreciation means fall in the value of a currency in a floating exchange rate system. But the statement first is incorrect because currency depreciation increases a country's export activity because now the products and services become cheaper to buy. But a weak domestic unit can increase a country's import bill as well. And RBI intervenes to support the falling rupee directly in the currency market to increase the rupee value by selling dollars, not buying. That's why statement second was incorrect. Also, RBI can adjust the repo rate and liquidity ratio to control rupee. And the context is that the rupee closed at a record low of 76.53 against the US dollar on 16th April 2020 recently. Now, question number 3 is, consider the following statement. First, stalactite is a type of geological formation that rises up from the floor of the cave. Second, stalagmite and stalactites fuse to give rise to a columns and pillars of different diameters. So, if statement first is incorrect, second is correct, so option will be B, that is second only. So, here is the image is given. Above one is stalactite and below one is stalagmite. And stalactite is a type of geological formation that hangs from the ceiling of caves. And they are composed of lava, minerals, mud, peat, pit, sand and cinders. Whereas stalagmites rise up from the floor of the cave. and eventually they both fuse to give rise to columns and pillars of different diameters. One more thing, you can remember both the terms in a way, like stalactites have a word C which means ceiling, and here stalagmite have G which means ground. Now let's move to the next question. Now question number 4 is, the term social recession was recently used, so it refers to which of the following? So it refers to the collapse of social context. So option will be B. And the term is very important because economic recession most of us all know, but terms like social recession we hardly focus on. And last year UPSC asked about social capital, so it might ask regarding social recession. So do remember this term, it means collapse in social context. And recently, due to COVID-19 pandemic, it has caused a kind of fear for economic recession and also social recession. And both loneliness and social isolation can trigger stress hormones that produce psychological changes. And it can have profound physical and psychological effects, and long-term forced isolation increase the risk of premature death as well. But unfortunately, following lockdown guidelines are also important to stay at home and safe. Now question number 5 is, which of the following is a tri-state protected area declared an eco-sensitive zone recently? So the correct one is National Chamban Sanctuary. So option will be B. So here the map is given. It is a sanctuary which is a tri-state protected area in northern India and located in the state of Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan, and it is declared as an eco-sensitive zone recently. And the sanctuary starts from the Vindhya range along with the Chambal river and ends at the Yamuna river, and it is home to 75% of gharials. Once UPSC has also asked regarding the gharials habitation, and the answer was the Chambal sanctuary. So you have to focus on these terms as well. Now question number 6 is, recently continuous process industries were in use. So which of the following industries have been included under continuous process industries in Uttar Pradesh recently? First refinery, then chemical, then sugar mills, then fourth fertilizer. So here the incorrect one is sugar mill. So we eliminate third, it will be A. And statement third is incorrect because continuous process industries include steel, refinery, cement, chemical, foundries, fertilizer, clothes, except apparel, paper, tire, common effluent treatment plants and sugar mills as well. And continuous process industries are units which would be allowed to operate with certain conditions from April 20. So this list might get changed, but as of now, the above given industries are deemed as continuous process industries in Uttar Pradesh guidelines. Also, they have to maintain social distancing at work, and the order also warns that if it is found that units are not following the guidelines, they could be shut down. Now question number 7 is, why are gold prices rising? So consider the following statement. First, the depreciation of rupee vis-a-vis the US dollar. Second, COVID impact. Third, announcement of liquidity injection by the RBI. As we have to find out incorrect one. So here, all the given statements are correct. So option will be D, none of the above. So if any expansion in paper currency is done, it push up the gold prices. And apart from this, major gold buying leading central banks of China and Russia over the last 2 years supported higher gold prices. Well, gold itself does not produce any economic value. It is an effective tool to hedge against inflation and economic uncertainty. And it is also more liquid when compared with real estate and many debt instruments which come with a lock-in period. And after many major economic crash and recession, gold prices continue with upward run. One more thing is that majority of the gold is imported by India. So if currency will depreciate, the gold price will increase. Now question number 8 is, recently post-intensive care syndrome was in news. So consider the following statement. First, it can happen to any person who has been in the ICU. Second, psychological disability may also arise in a person. So these kind of questions check your common sense. So if we are talking about post intensive care syndrome, so this means this statement first and statement second both are correct. So option will be C. And post intensive care syndrome comprises impairment in cognition, psychological health and physical function of a person who has been in the ICU, and it is recommended that to avoid patients, use of deep sedation is limited and early mobilization is encouraged, along with giving them aggressive physical and occupational therapy. And various new reports have pointed out that some COVID-19 patients who needed intensive care after leaving the ICU may suffer from post-intensive care syndrome. Now question number 9 is, in which of the following elections proportional representation with open ballot system has been used? So in the given election, it is not used in vice president's election, not in president's election, not in speaker's election. So option will be D, none of the above. So D is correct because open ballot voting system is applied to election in Council of State, that is Rajya Sabha only. And under Rule 39AA of the Conduct of Election Rules 1961, at the time of polling for the election of Rajya Sabha, every elector belonging to a political party has to show his marked ballot paper to the authorized representative of his party before inserting it into the ballot box. And any refusal on his part to show his marked ballot paper to his party representative would render his ballot paper liable to rejection. And this was allowed under Representation of the People's Act 1951. Now question number 10 is, which of the following is located on the westernmost direction? So the correct answer is Sundar State. So here is the map is given. You can see the westernmost is Sundar, then Lombok, Banda Sea and Timur Sea. And the easternmost given here is Arafura Sea. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And now you can see the index, what we have covered today. Now today's question for you is, where is the headquarter of World Health Organization? If you know it, please answer it in the comment section. If you don't know, please Google it. Also subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the videos. And if you want to contact us, you can contact through the given details. We are always there to help you. Also, you can get the information regarding UPPSC examination 2020 and its test series. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day, and thank you.